Okay, so you're scrolling through your Pinterest and you're just looking for some really cute clothes. And you decide, why don't I just type in cheap casual clothes, see what pops up. So you type that into your Pinterest account and you start scrolling through, and there's a lot of cute stuff to choose from. There's one maybe thing that catches your eye. I kind of like, yeah, all of these are kind of cute. Go kind of up a little bit more, and you see this one on the far right. Click on it, and it takes you to this website called Chic in Dress. Chic in Dress. Wow. So, yeah, it's really cute. It's got a lot of really cute, amazing looking clothes. All of them are pretty cheap considering they're very stylish and they look just really like good material overall. And so, you know, you start scrolling through, you find all of these really cute clothes. You know, you have to have a certain amount in your cart in order to get free shipping. But then you start to look at, okay, what kind of reviews does this website have? Chic in Dress. I started looking through and I found a slew of really bad reviews. People were saying things like, nothing fits. The way the quality looks on the photo is nothing like what it looks like in real life. What you get is not at all what you thought you ordered. So, is it a scam? The answer is yes. So, you know, based on the various reviews that I've looked at and just combed through, so many people have complained about this company just taking their money. And saying, okay, well, you know, it says on the website that there's free returns, you know, that people, the return policy is you can return it within 30 days. And the reality is, you can't really return it and get your full money back. It comes from China. They say that you have to pay for the shipping costs to ship it back to China. And that can cost upwards of $45. So they charge you for that. And if you want to return it, you have to pay that amount. And in some cases, they've just offered people store credit. In other cases, they've basically said, too bad, we're not giving you your money back. It's just kind of all across the board. So for the most part, people have complained the clothes just not looking anything like what it actually looks like on the website. People have complained of just everything just not fitting right. It just fits like 10 times smaller than normal clothes fit. They come with holes. I mean, just it's all over. The complaints are crazy. So this right here is actually the website. So then we go to Amazon, and I wanted to see something. So I actually took the description of the coat that we just saw, typed it into Amazon, and look what popped up. So Sin Shein is the store. And they actually have this same coat. And so I was looking at the photos and I said, huh, this one looks familiar. This is the same one for that was in Chic in Dress. Chic in Dress has that same exact one. The prices are a little different, but that's definitely the same one. These are all photos that are in Chic in Dress as well. So you kind of start scrolling through, and they actually have some reviews on Amazon. So different customers have said different things. You know, there's some really bad reviews. It's kind of all across the board. But then you start to look at the good reviews, the five-star reviews, and what people are saying. And there's one that I came across that was kind of interesting. This one from Dilha. So I love it, 5 stars. It's very stylish, and there's a picture of this person wearing it. It's a verified purchase according to Amazon. Perfect. Got this, and it's very soft. You know, some very positive reviews. And then I said, huh, interesting how she's posing. It just doesn't look like an amateur photo. So I scrolled all the way up to, you know, the store itself, and this is actually the same model. And the same photos taken, you know, these are from the website and they're actually the same one. So that was a fake review. I looked at this other one, this gray one in particular, and same thing, this one that I originally clicked on from Pinterest that was really cute. The funny thing about this one is actually the wording in here. So it kind of just starts talking gibberish and saying things like, okay, so that last bullet says 2020 women's XL tank top, tankini top, summer cotton, juniors, girls, sexy junior tunics, plus size, blue ladies, quick dry. I thought, okay, interesting. But you go on, it says skirt leggings, brown toddler, okay, girl, shirts, yoga, tunic, short tube, men tennis, teenage tees, blouses, teen cheap men's card game, training, transparent tees. It's a different language here. I mean, even at the very top, it's kind of funny. It says, if you belong to a thin group, choose the smallest size possible, but it also needs to be combined with height to choose. If you belong to the overweight group, please choose the largest size as much as possible. So the English is very poor. I don't know. I guess they're just trying to say, just if you're a small size, order small. If you're a large size, order larger. But then the second bullet just kind of has all this gibberish, and I think they're just trying to get into the algorithm. So whatever you type, they're just trying to figure out what people would type into Amazon and search for and maybe put that in there. I don't know. It's kind of weird. But this is the same exact tunic that was in the Chic In dress. This is another one that's super cute. The brand is generic. It comes in different colors, but same exact dress from the Chic In dress website. So I found a bunch of these. If you look at the Chic In dress website and you type it into Amazon, the description of it, you find all of these dresses that pretty much are in Chic In dress and also sold by Amazon, but under different store names, under different brand names. So it's just really sketchy. The reviews are kind of all over the place, but I did notice that a lot of the positive reviews were from fake accounts. So, a lot of it is just not legit. So just watch out for this company. If you're ever scrolling through Pinterest, just be careful. If you click on something and you like it, just do a little bit more research and find out, what other people are saying about it, because if it looks like it's too good to be true, it probably is. Thank you so much for listening, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.